I am a lifestyle slave.
There are many people in many places, of many standards, and everyone has their own different aspects, and everything is all kept into its own little realm of secrecy. Now, someone may argue, is this nature, or is this nurture, or is this just fantasy? Someone who lives day to day a normal life and can, you know, operate in everyday society with their inclinations, especially if it has to do with fantasy as BDSM lifestyle. And I don't think there's anything wrong with that. And, you know, I don't think there's anything wrong with that. No, there's anything wrong with that. When you don't define the line, well, that's when a lot of things go wrong.
Oh, I'm sorry. You want to try it again?
Now, when someone steps out and decides that they want to be more public with something,
when you type in to Google, this is just what pops up. First slave. On the free dictionary, they say one bound in servitude as the property of a person or household. One who is objectively subservient to a specified person or influence. I think those are pretty relatable for people in the lifestyle. A person entirely under the domination of an influence or person. I mean, it's not a, you know, when it's lifestyle, that's one thing, that's lifestyle slavery. A person who is the legal property of another and is forced to obey them. I'm sure a lot of people see it that way and always see slavery as a bad thing. A point that I was bringing up is that this. Lifestyle slavery is not the same thing as legal slavery.
Oh, I'm sorry. You want to try it again?
Let me get to my throne, woman. Oh, you see what I'm getting at? It's powerful, powerful.
Oh, I'm sorry. You want to try it again?
You'll be sorry, baby.
What I'm trying to say is not to forget.
I've been cursed.
Laying in his bed, repeat yesterday's mistake.
I've been shattered by the ones I thought I loved.
Oh, I'm sorry. You want to try it again?
DJ running that back once more.
Oh, I'm sorry.
DJ running that back once more.
When I come to make him, he won't.